Yes, promotion to Elite. Finally, Triple Elite after 4 years of playing this game. But bear in mind, it didn't take me 4 years working on combat rank. I played this game basically without worrying about combat rank too much. Doing PvP, a lot of background simulation stuff, and worked my way up to Master, which took, I don't know, probably a good couple of years. Advancing your combat rank doing ship-to-ship combat takes an extremely long time. Just to go from deadly to elite, which is only one step, you have to have 1,780 elite kills. Just think about that for a moment. 1,780 elite kills. I mean, how much time do you have to play this game? Imagine going to Hazrez's site, waiting for elites to spawn in, killing them, waiting for more elites. There's no guarantee you're going to kill them every time. Because it gets exponentially harder and harder the more you move up in combat rank to find targets that are above you in combat rank, which is the only way you can progress. And you progress very slowly, and it can take forever. And now there are people who want to play this game the slow. What is wrong with this guy? He is stuck in the table. That's a trip. They want to experience the gameplay, and they want to do it the, I don't necessarily say the hard way, but they want to do it just through straight gameplay with no shortcuts. And that's perfectly fine if that's the way you want to do it. Everybody has their own gameplay style. I feel like I have earned Elite anyway through so much gameplay, so much combat. I have more Corvette rebuys than anybody in the history of this game. I have a lot of PvP experience. I didn't necessarily have all that good at it, but I have a lot of experience at it. And I have earned this Elite rank, I believe, in my opinion. And in a video game, your opinion is the only one that matters, right? So for those who want to go ahead and get this Elite Combat rank in a much quicker way, this is the video for you, because I have discovered a fast way to do it. And it's not necessarily the best, it's not the greatest, it's still a grind. It is still a grind. Let me get that through your head right off the bat. It still takes a while, but after 4 years of working my way up to Master, I went through Dangerous, Deadly, and to Elite using this method in probably 2 weeks of straight grinding this method out. So I'm going to share it with you, and let's get into it. Now, for starters, you definitely want to have at least a grade 3 Dominator suit, grade 3 or higher, because you will be grade 3, you can do it probably, but you'll be dying a lot more. So grade 5 would be nice, but you need to go ahead and do what you got to do to get up to grade 3 at least, and a grade 3 in your weapons at least. And this here is the most crucial thing, a grenade launcher. A grenade launcher, at least grade 3 or higher, is necessary for this technique. It is very important, because this is all you're going to be doing pretty much in this method is spamming this grenade launcher. And for the other weapon, I'm going to use the Manticore Intimidator. It's a level 4 at present. No, it's grade 5, I'm sorry. And it only takes 2 shots to put them down, so. Alright, and you pick you a nice little settlement. Needless to say, it needs to be Anarchy Settlement, so you don't get any bounties, because the only reason you're coming here is to kill everybody in sight. You want as many kills as possible in the shortest amount of time. Okay, and for this system, this is my little spot that I found. And it is right here in the Dejanaura system, D-J-I-N-A-U-R-A. Same place as my other little video on how to raid a settlement. Because I'm so familiar with this layout. And we're right here at Dejanaura 2. And on this planet is Schneider's synthetic base. This is my little spot that I've been coming to for probably 2 weeks straight, doing nothing but smearing these people all over the place. Extremely low temperature. Now, of course, first thing you want to do is to get your security profile so the doors will open for you. This is why we're not using a Maverick suit, because you don't need to cut no doors open. This is why you're getting the profile, so the doors will open for you. You're not going to have enough time to cut doors open, and it's a waste of time. You want to do this run as quick as possible. Wait on my guy here. You want to do each run as quick as possible. Jump to Super Cruise. I'll show you about that later. So it'll all re-instance, and you can do it all over again. For every one of these runs, every one of these battles, you'll go up around 2%. All right, we're going to bust on up in here. Now that we got our profile. Oop, ouch. Go ahead and take care of this guy. Go ahead and take care of this guy. Get to the security room as fast as possible. The key here, just about any base would work that you're comfortable with. The most important thing is to make sure there's only one way into the room, and that there is an ammo crate in that room. As they come in, you want the settlement alarms to go off. Well, let me leave that out. You don't want to disable the alarms. You want the alarms going off because you want all of them to come to you. Reload every chance you get. You only get 8 rounds in this grenade launcher. So every time you use it and you get a quick break, reload as many whenever you get a chance. There's my little promotion to elite thing again. Spam this rocket launcher. Go ahead and pull out the shotgun for these guys that don't have no shields. This is why the rocket launcher is crucial for this, because if you place it right, the rocket launcher will take out 2, sometimes 3 of these guys all at the same time. And when you don't have the settlement alarms disengaged, they will come busting up in on you deep. But again, the crucial element, find a room where there's only one way in so they can't come in from behind you. Make sure there's an ammo crate in the room with you, and you have at least a grade 3 suit and a grade 3 rocket launcher. And pretty much you just spam this sucker as they come in, wipe them all out. This particular room here is good because you got this fallback position here with this wall you can hide behind. But it takes a good second to reload this rocket launcher. You can see how slowly it reloads. Refill ammo every chance you get. Hit the fallback position. Whenever you get a chance, move up to this corner here. You can see both doors. Anybody comes in, fire off a grenade. You've got 2 health kits and 2 energy cells anyway. And that's all you'll really need. And they generally tend to come in waves. You're going to get about 3. See, that took out, I don't know, probably all 3 of them, at least 2 of them. Fall back to this one. You're dead. Back up to my little corner here. Give us a quick reload. Refill every chance you get. Take one of my little energy cells real quick. Jack it on up. Oh, see, I got stuck with only 1. Yeah, they're coming deep around that corner. Nip it in the bud and catch them way on back there when you can. If they bum rush in too quick, like they're doing now, you got your fallback spot. Fall back toward this little corner. Or this beam, whatever this is, right? Oh, that took care of at least 2 of them. Quick refill. Trying to come in on me. Every time you do this, you're going to go up about 1-2%. Every time. So you can go probably somewhere between 50 to 60 battles, I would say. And you'll move up in rank. And yes, that is still a lot of battles. Like I said, it is still a grind. but it is by far the fastest way to go from deadly to elite, or to move up in any rank for that matter. Because, I mean, imagine 1,780 kills just to go from deadly to elite. How many is it to go all the way from harmless to elite? You know, I mean, 5,000? 6,000? I mean, I haven't done the math, but it just seems like a ridiculous long period of time. After the second or third wave, I usually push up to about right here. You can see both doors try to come in on you. After about three waves, you wait a minute, you don't see nobody. It's time to hit the ship and re-instance it all over. Just run back out to the old ship. Jump the super cruise, immediately drop back out, do a 180, you come back down, do it all over again. Pretty much works the same way when you die. You'll respawn up in space, jump the super cruise, point straight down at it, go wide open. Far quicker than flying way out and turning around and coming back. The key here is zero thrust. Use your boost only. No thrust, just your boost. Get your frameshift drive first chance you get. And immediately drop back out at zero throttle. Do a 180 and you should be, sometimes you're 10 kilometers above the place, sometimes it's 15, sometimes it's 20. And this time we wound up about 18 kilometers above it. And it only takes a second to fly back down. And request docking, they'll dock your ship, and you can do it all over again. As I said, it is a grind, but it's about the fastest way that I've ever discovered to move up in combat rank. You probably use just about any settlement that you're comfortable with, one that you've been to a few times and that you know the layout. You know where there's a room with an ammo crate in it. You got your level 3 suit and a level 3 grenade launcher. Just get in there and just spam that grenade launcher and wipe these people out. And you'll move right on up pretty quick in your combat rank. As I say, every time you do one of these runs, you can move up between 1% to 2%. It really won't show up until after you have logged out. When you log back in the game, you check your rank on Inara, and you'll see that you're steadily moving right on up there. Well, I hope this has been informative. And I wish you guys the best of luck, and we will see you next time.